Welcome to our channel where we discuss more existing updates on the XRP and cryptocurrency. I want to be talking about how much Kaspa you should be holding. And in this video, we're going to go over a few points that you should be considering before you ever invest in Kaspa at all. And then we're going to be going into looking at future projections of Kaspa, where it might go in the future. And, you know, I don't personally like price predictions, but when I do talk about price predictions, I like to look in terms of market cap and just look at possibilities. But of course, none of this is for sure going to happen. It's not guaranteed. These are just my opinions and how I view this entire financial situation when you're looking into Kaspa. So here are the first few points when you're trying to figure out how much Kaspa you should have. Truly, the first thing you need to do is research. I have this in all caps because this is the primary thing that you need to do before you invest in Kaspa, is to understand why you are buying Kaspa. So many people get into Kaspa and they see the chart and it looks awesome. And then they want to purchase some Kaspa. And then sometimes they ask me, well, how much should I put in? How much this is and that? And I'm like, dude, like, seriously, I highly encourage you to research, maybe watch my videos and learn about what you're buying. Truly, if you don't understand what you're buying, this is going to cause you to probably sell too early because you start to get emotional with your investment. You don't fully understand what you're getting yourself into. And then you know it can hurt you in the future. So the first thing you need to do is research. Kaspa. If you want to start getting involved with Kaspa, please do your research. This is primary. Then once you do your research and you're like, okay, I have some money that I do want to invest. Now you need to make sure this money is money that you're willing to lose. My current financial situation, if Kaspa was to go to zero, worst case scenario, I know that that would suck. Of course it would suck, but my life would continue going on. It would not disrupt how I live my life day to day. There would still be food on the table. The bills would still be met. And that is my position currently. I hope everyone who's investing in crypto or any investments doesn't matter. You're in that position because if you're not, you are setting yourself up for a very, very ugly situation, especially very important to have a strong cash position. In my opinion, I think it's smart to do, especially now in the US where interest rates are pretty high. This means high yield savings accounts are going to be pretty high. So right now I'm saving my cash in a high yield savings account that's giving me about like 5%. And I'm only doing that because I'm planning on getting a house within the next year or so. So I do want to keep some cash on the side that has no volatility, but it's still making me money. It's still making 5% interest, which is perfect. So please, you know, make sure you're putting money that you are willing to lose, because anything you lose is truly on you. The next thing is your debts. I have zero debt. I have no debt. And this will help you with your investing journey. If you have no debt because you don't have that kind of just hovering over you, that you need to pay these bills and pay them down and whatnot. Because that's always difficult when you do have debts. And I always tell people, like, listen, if you got debts, I would say try to get those knocked out as quickly as possible. If you don't have those finished, knocked out as quickly as possible first, you probably want to make sure you're not putting way too much into investments. But of course, if you want to consider cash flow, just consider getting a decent sized bag to start and then focus on those debts. Because you don't want to have debts. The next thing you want to think about is taxes. A lot of people don't talk about this too much. They kind of just leave that for you to decide. But seriously, do your research on taxes. I know for like the US, if you hold for 1 year, you can avoid a lot of taxes. So if you're planning on buying gas, but think about the fact that, hey, if I sell this before 1 year, I'm going to have to pay a lot of taxes. So it wouldn't make sense if I'm only able to invest, let's say $1,000, and then the Kaspa rises in profit, only another $1,000. You know, if you sell that and it's not even been a year, you're going to lose a lot in taxes there. So just make sure you do your research on taxes. And then the last thing we're going to get into is, of course, the future potential. And to understand the future potential, you need to understand how the crypto market works. And you know about market cap and supply, and that's what we're going to be going into right now. So if we're looking at Kaspa, currently the circulating supply is at 22.6 billion right now. Now, if you don't already know how the emission schedule works for Kaspa, you can go ahead and Kaspa and see how the emission schedule works. This emission schedule prints more Kaspa into existence. And the way Kaspa gets into existence is through proof of work mining, which is how Kaspa is secured and how the network is run. It's run through proof of work, mining the people who are mining new Kaspa into existence and securing the train. And currently you can see that right now, the current reward for Kaspa is 131 Kaspa per block. There's a block every single second. So if you do the math, you can figure out how much Kaspa is being emitted every single day and every single month. There's also another chart that you can go to on kaspa.org. And if you go to about Kaspa and go to the tokenomics, you could see a PDF file that shows you the release schedule by months. And it could tell you how much Kaspa is in existence by each of those months here. So once you look into that, you're going to start seeing how much Kaspa is left to mine and then how much is being mined each month. So right now, if we're looking for 2024, we're currently in February. You can see that this month there's going to be 344 million Kaspa mined. So 344 new Kaspa created, and this dilutes the price. So that means it's going to dilute the future price potential. When we're looking at how high Kaspa can go, the max supply of Kaspa is 28.7 billion. So to put this in simple terms, right now the total supply is 2.6 billion. And if you want to, if Kaspa wants to go to a dollar, if you want to see Kaspa at a dollar, there needs to be $22 billion that gets invested into Kaspa. So now that we know how this pretty much works, how the pricing works, it's because of the market cap and then the supply and how much is the max supply. Now we look at the other coins that are above it and see how high they went in market cap in previous cycles to maybe get a good idea of where Kaspa could potentially go. And we can see currently Bitcoin's at $947 billion worth of market cap. Now, anyone who's calling for Kaspa to go to this market cap, I think it is greatly just not realistic at all. There has never been a coin that has gone over 500 billion market cap other than really Ethereum. Ethereum, the last bull market was able to get up to, I think it was very just barely above 500. We're talking about 500. Well, actually went to 552 billion. So it almost was trying to get to 600 billion, but it didn't get that high. Ethereum was the second highest market cap in the last bull run. And so looking at that, I truly do not believe Kaspa could get to even 500 billion this market cap. Now, some people like to go even higher with Kaspa possibly getting to a 200 billion market cap, which we'll see if that's possible here. But yeah, if we keep going down the list, you could see that the top two are the highest market caps. And then after that, you have a huge drop off. The stablecoin USD doesn't count. This is just a dollar stablecoin that's it's pegged to the US dollar. So this doesn't count the next cryptocurrency, like cryptocurrency that exists that has a market cap in it is $47 billion. And then after that, it just keeps dropping down below until we get to Kaspa, which is currently sitting at number 28 at $3.2 billion. So this is when you can go ahead and start comparing Kaspa to other coins that have similar market cap, similar attention, and basically like a similar run, similar fundamentals. And that's when you just research a little bit of other coins. So some coins that Kaspa gets compared to are something like Cardano. Cardano was a coin that didn't even have smart contracts during the last bull run and was still able to get pretty high. So we could see here that in the last bull run, Cardano went to about a 91 billion market cap. Now, that's pretty much for today. I hope you learned something new. Keep an eye out for upcoming content where we'll discuss everything you need to know about XRP. Don't forget to share this video with your friends who are cryptocurrency enthusiasts and like it if you find this useful and informative.